This is Karthik Shenoy. Today we are going to talk about XML signature wrapping attacks. For communication with cloud servers, simple object access protocol is used. Messages exchanged are in an XML format like this. The body is processed by the server. Now, to protect the data from modifications, ID referencing is used. Also, to ensure integrity, an XML signature is added in the header tag. The XML signature typically has this structure. The reference tag will store the reference of the element whose signed digest is computed. Both the timestamp and the body are signed in case it is sent over an insecure transport channel, while only the timestamp is signed when sent over a secure channel. For securing the channel, SSL or TLS may be used. There are four types of XML signature wrapping attacks. They are simple ancestry context, optional element context, sibling value context, and sibling order context. Now, we are going to discuss the simple ancestry context attack. This attack cannot be performed if the request is directly sent to a cloud server, but if there is a middle tier such as a firewall or proxy server through which the request must be sent, the attacker can gain access to this middle tier and access this message. This is possible since SSL or TLS involves point-to-point communication and will be decrypted at this middle tier. This vulnerability was demonstrated on the AWS servers. Let's see how the message is modified to conduct this attack. Initially, the message will be framed like this. Here, the signature is for the element with ID as CMPE, which is the ID of the body tag. This body tag has a symbol IBM. After this message is received by the server, it will first verify that the timestamp and the CMP element have not been modified by verifying the signature. Now, the attack could transform the message into something like this. Here, the original body element is added into a wrapper inside the header. The original body tag has been replaced. When this message is received by the server, it will see that the signature of the CMPE element needs to be verified. It searches for this element, finds it and validates the signature. The server finds out that the integrity of the body tag has not been altered. During further processing, this tag gets ignored since it is there in the wrapper and the new body tag is used as data, which has the symbol MBI. This is possible since for signature verification, the path of the element is not specified, instead just the ID is mentioned. The solution to this attack as proposed is using REST over SOAP. This is because it provides encryption by default to many data formats. Thank you for watching. If you have any doubts, please write them in the comment section below. Also, hit the like button if you like this video and subscribe to my channel if you want to receive notifications of more such videos.